Students, in our today's class we are going to study a new chapter, that is data handling, chapter number 15 from your class 4 mathematics textbook. So in your previous class you have studied the collection of data, writing it in the form of a table, representing the data through pictures, isn't it? Now here are some pictures of flowers. Look at this flowers carefully and answer the questions below. Now see, the first one is the rose, right? How many roses are there here? You see here, there are 10 roses. There are 10 roses. See, you have to write that number 10 here. There are 10 roses. Next flower is sunflower. How many sunflowers are there here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So there are 8 sunflowers. Hibiscus. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 5 hibiscus. Then lotus. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 5 lotus. From this data, we came to know that there are 10 roses, 5 lotus, 8 sunflowers and 5 hibiscus. Now tell me, which flowers are more in number? Which flowers are more in number? Roses are more in number. It is 10. You see here, roses are more in number. Which flowers are less in number? Which flowers are less in number? Hibiscus and lotus. Hibiscus and lotus. Which flowers are of same number? Which flowers are of same number? That is, hibiscus and lotus are of same numbers. It is 5. What is the total number of flowers? What is the total number of flowers? You have to add here. You have to add here. Okay, 10 plus 8 is 18. 18 plus 5 plus 5 is? So you see here, the total is 28. 10 plus 5 plus 8 plus 5. It is 28. So you have to answer these questions here. Which flowers are more in number? It is roses. Which flowers are less in number? Lotus and hibiscus. Which flowers are of same number? That is lotus and hibiscus. What is the total number of flowers? It is 28. It is 28. Now, this data can be represented using this graph. We call these as bars, and this data is a bar graph. You see here, where the number of flowers is represented and the types of flowers are represented here. Here if you see, the information or the data is represented by bars. We call it as bars, okay? That is B-A-R, bars, and we call this data as bar graph. We call this data as bar graph. See the second example. Here they have written the names of flowers, and here weight of the flowers sold in kg. These are the weight of flowers sold in kg. First you see, this is the bar of jasmine. Jasmine, how many years straight if you see? 9. That means 9 kg of jasmine has been sold. Okay. Second one is marigold. Marigold is, you see here, last line and come here towards the y-axis. If you see, it is 6. That means 6 kg of marigold has been sold. See the next one, rose. Here, come straight to the y-axis, it is 4. That means 4 kg of roses are sold out. Last one is the dendro. It is sold. How many kgs? 2 kg of these flowers are sold. Now let us answer the question. Which flowers are sold maximum? Which flowers are sold maximum? It is jasmine. Jasmine. Which flowers are sold minimum? To see here, it is deander are sold minimum. What is the total weight of flowers sold? So you have to find out. Jasmine is 9 kg. Marigold is how much? It is 6. Plus rose is 4 kg. And deodar is, it is 2 kg. You have to add this. So 9 plus 6 plus 4 plus 2. It is how much? 21. 9 plus 6 plus 4 plus 2. It is 21. Which are sold less than 5 kg? Rose and deodar. Which are sold less than 5 kg but more than 2 kg? Among these, which are sold less than 5 kg but more than 2 kg? It is roses. It is what right here? Roses. How to represent these data in a bar graph? Think. So name of the competition, number of students participated. So 10 students have taken part in Bhava Gita, 20 in debate, 25 in essay writing and 15 in allocation. Now clear representation is given here, that is in the form of a bar graph. Name of the competition and number of students participated. Now let us answer these questions. Observe the above bar graph and answer the following questions. What is explained in the bar graph? What is explained in the bar graph is the number of students participated in various competition. It is data about participation of students in various competitions. It is the data about participation of students in various competitions. In which competition did maximum number of students participated? In which competition? In essay writing. In essay writing. Essay writing. In which competition did the minimum number of students participated? It is Bhava Gita. It is Bhava Gita. How many students participated in the competition? So you have to find out the total number of students. It is 10 plus 20 plus 25 plus 15. So 10 plus 20 is 30. 30 plus 25 is 55. 55 plus 15 is 70. Among debate and allocation, in which one did more number of students participated? Between debate and allocation. So in debate, more number of students had taken part. It is debate. Let us move on to the exercise. Exercise 15.1. The bar chart of favorite food items liked by 25 students of a class is given. Observe this and answer the following questions. So along the x-axis, they have given about tiffins, various food items, that is idli, chapati, dosa and puri. Here they have given number of students. Okay. So idli, it is how much? It is 9. So it is 9. And chapati, it is 8. Dosa, it is 5. Puri, it is 3. Now let us answer the questions. Which food item liked by maximum number of students? It is idli. Which food item is likely liked by more than 6 students but less than 8? More than 6 but less than 8 is chapati. Which food item is liked by more than 4 students but less than 7? It is dosa. Which food item is liked by very few students? It is puri. Now see the second question. The number of animals in a zoo are represented in a bar graph. Construct the table and write the details. So you see here number of animals and the name of animals. It is lion. Lion, there are 5. Deer, there are 20. Rabbit, there are 10. And monkeys, there are 15. You have to construct the table. I have constructed the table here. You see here, first write the name of the animal and number of animals. First is lion. Lion is 5. Deer is 20. Rabbit is 10. And monkeys 15.